Hi. Attained the age of 85 on 4th of September 2013 and I wanted that I should share my memories with members of my family. Future, so that if they want to learn something from my experiences of life, they may use it. Before I start my memories, my past days of 85 years, I wholeheartedly and from the core of my heart, I pay my reverences to my respected mother, Srimati Vidyavati Datta, whose blessings and ashirvad I am continuously receiving every day, every moment from the heavens. I will be failing in my duty if I do not remember my revered father, Chaudhary Mohyal Dutt, who was equally a parent to me, and I am proud to be his son because I have most of my qualities of head and heart imbibed in me. My physical structure my bodybuilding everything depicts his shadow of physical structure in me. I also bow my head to the sacred feet on this occasion so that they may give me enough courage, knowledge of speech to say whatever is in my heart, which I have learnt from my educative career, which has been outstanding right from the primary classes to middle classes to high classes, even to college days. Parents are not found once they are gone. It is their memory and their blessings which keep one fresh and alive, and they not only increase their own stature in public life. It is said, this gentleman so and so is the son of so and so, his mother was so and so, his grandfather was so and so, his parental grandfathers were so and so, his maternal grandfathers were so and so. All these backgrounds are very, very well known even in the modern era. See, when we sit in the society, the older generation, when they recognize us, they ask one another, who is this gentleman? Somebody says, he is grandson of so and so. And somebody says, his Nana ji was so and so. Somebody says, his Mama ji was so and so. So these are the decorations, these are the qualities which are imbibed in me, and I am proud of both my maternal grandparents and my paternal grandparents. Starting from my childhood, I say that I had two sisters and one brother elder to me. My father and mother they were married, as per my knowledge, as I have heard, at the ages of 16 and 21. My father was working in the government medical store depot, Lahore, Kent, which was under the Ministry of Health at that time. It was a military organization at that time. My mother, daughter of Azada Bihari Lal Bali and his beloved wife, popularly known as in the family, she was known as Vaddi ji. Unfortunately, when he was recruited, he was about 21 years of age in the government organization as store assistant, became an assistant office superintendent in 1929. Having four children at the age of 29, she passed away on 5th of December 1929 when I was hardly an innocent breastfeeding baby of about 20 months. When I was born, I was the fourth child. There was a lot of rejoicing, there was a lot of happiness, there was a lot of joy, there was a lot of celebrations in the family. But when my father left us, my mother was mentally upset. Bodily, she was bodily broken, but she was a courageous lady. And her brothers, her mother, her father, they supported her. and she plucked up courage to survive, because my father, who belonged to Kanjrud Datta, we had lot of agricultural land, we had havelis, we have houses, we had lot of property at our parental house. So they decided, in our interest, in the interest of my mother, to migrate at once to Kanjrud and take charge of her inherited property, which was at that time worth crores of rupees. We all, the four children and my mother, they migrated to Kanjrud. My Nani ji told her sons to take care of the family. If they are so faithful to her sister, they should look after the family at their native place. And I am proud to say that my maternal uncles Ramnath Bali, Tarachand Bali and Puranchand Bali, they were all very much alive to their duties, and they looked after welfare even in our village. And the whole village and five villages around, they respected my mother because she was a very bold lady. She was very well known. She was a lady of very high moral character, a lady with a courage, a lady to face the atrocities of life, a lady who could face anything in life. And I am happy to say that when I was 5 years of age, a very good house was built for us. A very good house was built for us, which was very much on the roadside and very, very happy. We lived there up to 1947. The senior members of the village showered their blessings on my mother, not because of that she was wife of so and so, so and so, but her alertness in mind, her mental courage to support the family. I may add here, when my father passed away at the age of 29 at Lahore, the entire establishment of the Government of India was closed. Even the British Medical Hospital was closed. Even the Lahore Kent shops were closed. There was a dismay. There was a sadness in the whole Lahore Kent. And thanks to the Government of India, thanks to the British government, our pension was refused by the Government of India because my father had put in only hardly 9 years of service and no pension was entitled to him. But as I have come to know, when I grew up, our pension was granted by Her Majesty Queen of England on humanitarian grounds, on the basis of my father's exemplary service, selfless services. He was devoted, dedicated, a selfless worker. He was a young man. People were envious to see him. The officers, I named them, Mr. Goss, Mr. Lepsley. They took his dead body on their shoulders to the burial ground, to the cremation ground. They were all in tears and they helped. And loud voice said to my mother, that they will leave no stone unturned to get us pension, what may be. When it was rejected by the Indian Director of Audit and Accounts, matter was referred to Her Majesty and she was very pleased to grant the pension, which my mother was in receipt of pension till April 1993, and she enjoyed that pension for 64 years. You can imagine, if a man gets service at the age of 18 and retires at the age of 58, then what is the life, what is the span of his service? 40 years, my mother got pension for 64 years, and the last pension drawn was 750 rupees. I bow my head to the administration at Lahore Kent. I bow my head to the appellate authorities at British government, who were generous to grant that pension. We both the brothers were in receipt of pension up to the age of 18, and we both the brothers were visited time and again, off and on, year after year, in the schools, in the colleges, to see whether the sons of Mr. Manohar Lal are progressing, are reading, are studying in the school, colleges in a satisfactory way. And I am happy to record this today, that when my brother passed matriculation examination, my mother just told me and requested my Mamaji Tarachand Bali to take Roshan to Lahore Kent and just visit that office where their father was working. And I am happy to say, when my Mamaji Tarachand Bali took Roshan Lal to that office, people hugged him. They took him to the Director General, Mr. Windsor, and told him that he is son of so and so. And I record this for my family, that Roshan Lal was appointed then and there, without any interview, by Mr. Windsor, in recognition of the services rendered by my father 16 years back. There were people like this. There was one Mr. Babu Ram Bharadwaj. There was one Muslim office superintendent. There was one chief accounts officer, Mr. Abhi. They all welcomed my brother, and he was recruited within no time. The medical was held the following day. When he came back with his Mamaji, all my Mamaji, they were astonished And they went through that appointment letter over and over again, how this appointment has been held within one day in 1946, without any employment exchange, without any interview, without any test. When I was taken by my granddaughter, grandmother, to school, there was a school. It was called Urdu school. It was from first standard to eighth standard. Lala Laburam Mahajan of Malla was the headmaster. She took one year of Laddus and went to school. And when they asked her, what is the date of birth of the child? So she, being an illiterate lady, she, whatever she told, it was recorded. It was recorded at 4th of September 1928. But later on, when I became major, I talked to one of my cousins who was born on the same day at the same village, but he was born at Naniji's house, I was born at my parental house. So I just asked him, what is the exact date of birth? Your father was working in the railways, what is your date of birth? He told me 9th of October 1928. So according to the Vikram Samvat, our date of birth is Pachi Asu, 9th of October 1928. And I am happy to record this statement of mine on the eve of the beginning of Desi Mahina Ashwin tomorrow. My mother shifted to her own house, which was an accomplished residence with a hand pump. In those days, hand pumps were not in crude. People were drawing their water consumption from wells. Well, we had a hand pump with that boring, and all the nearby elders, relatives used to come to our house to fetch water. So when we started schooling, we were very well off. We never applied for any remission, any concession, any fee rebate. We were the first in the school and high school to deposit our fee the first week of. Our mother had a very high standard of life. And apart from all these things, socially, she was very much alive. She used to respect elders, love youngers, and the poor, the gali wale Musliman, the others, they used to come and request for certain things. But she was very liberal. She was brave hearted. She was lion hearted. Whenever I sleep, whenever I get up, I don't believe, but I say God is there, but He is more than a God for me. My father is more than a human being. My father, when I attained the age of 18 and my brother was employed in Lahore, the whole village used to say both these brothers, they are twins. We resembled so much from toe to head that we looked just like our father, young and hale and hearty. People loved us. We didn't have any foe in the, we didn't have any enemy in the village, enemy in five villages around. We were so popular, we were so dearly and affectionately loved by the people. They loved our father, they respected our mother. Our mother was not a human being. He was not simply a human being. She was supreme. And I say my grandmother, meri dadi, Prem Devi, used to say ke Manohar Lal jati dafa rizq ka chitta itna de gaya hai ke ye to maharani ki tarah rehti hai. So when I passed my matric, I was a scholarship holder. When I went to Lahore, my mama ji took me to government college, DAV college and SD college. I wanted some scholarship from the college. Government college refused. DAV college showed his unwillingness. Principal G.L. Datta was the principal. He said, I am a live member, I get 1 rupee as my pay. So how can I help you? Main kya, theek hai. Let us go to SD college. I am grateful to Vice Principal Badawaram. She belonged to Shagargat. When he saw my provisional certificate, he said, come on, I'll get you all the facilities. All the facilities in books, concession in fees, etc. But the condition is that you should show good results. But ill luck followed me. I promised with my mother that after my doing my BSc science, I'll go to Ludhiana in Agricultural University. And when I come back, I'll convert all this land nearby Kanjuru to Chandarke, which is about 10 to 15 killas. I wanted to convert that into an architect, but I couldn't continue my studies in further, and I had to content with those 600 rupees which I had in my pocket for my admission in BSc first year. Those 600 rupees were kept by my mother in her pocket, which we spent after partition at Gurdaspur during the month of September, October and November. On December 16, 1947, my mother told me those 600 rupees are going to relinquish, going to be spent. I went there without any recommendation. I went to Madhopur, entered a tent with a board, H.L. Datta. I talked to him. I want a job. What sort of job? I said, I am FSC first class, I want a job. So he took me to his residence and provided me with a job. At the same time, I worked there for 5 years. Remember, for five years, a boy, a collegiate of 18 or 19, without any experience, got a job for 5 years and came back to Gurdaspur with the news to my mother that I have been employed. See the Krishna of life. See the... See, God is great. God helps those who help themselves. I I never did anything during my life which would bring a bad name to my mother. Whatever I did, wherever I married, whenever I married with the permission, with the consent of my brother and my mother. I never took any decision myself. We were three left. My two sisters were gone within 1 year of the expiry of my father. I have a tremendous history. I have a very magnificent history. I have a very splendid and path-breaking history. I have a very great past, and my present is all the most tremendous. I will speak on my grandmother, Meri Dadi. We had a lasuda tree in our compound. Lasuda tree. Lasudas are used for pickle. They are very delicious. We used to give those lasudas and rotis to our farmers, to our field workers, to our agricultural. We had 50 killas of land. 50 killas, Punjakma. See, my grandfather's elder brother died issueless. He gave his entire property to my grandfather. Somebody told him, Chaudhary Sahib, you enjoy 50 killas yourself. You do yatras, four dham karo. Lekin my grandfather's elder brother severely bet that gentleman. He said, I have three daughters and three sons. What do you say? So, one should never say if he has done any good to those departed souls. But I want to record here, whenever God gives you enough courage, financially, mentally, spiritually, don't forget somebody is good done to you. It is a more serious offense than 302. If you murder somebody, that can be granted remission by the President of India. But if you are ungrateful, even God cannot forgive you. In 1987, when I had something, I first opened a trust in the name of my dead grandfather's elder brother and his wife, and people of my village, five people of my village were present in that meeting. They hugged me and said, you are the right person, you are the actual heir of that Chaudhary. What was his name? Do you remember? Yes, I remember first the name of my grandmother, Shiv Devi, and Chaudhary Narayan Das. Their name is recorded in the records of General Mehyal Sabha, and that will live forever. And the then editor, Mohyal Mitter, J.S. Bimwal, asked me what these five persons are talking about. Then I told him that I have repaid my loan to those elderly people. So I have the blessings of those people. I have the blessings of my elders. My Dadi, Prem Devi, used to love Roshan Lal very much because he was elder to me. She disliked me because when I was born, after some time, a year or so, my father passed away. But when I stood first in the school in fourth, I went for scholarship, got the scholarship in fourth, got the scholarship in eighth, stood first in the district in matric. They were even my Tayaji, my uncle, Chaudhary Thakur Das Dutt, SHO in Arkali Lahore, congratulated me and said, "You are the father of, you are the son of father of, you are the son of your father, Chaudhary Mohyal Dutt. Your father was a only person in our family who passed his matriculation from Narowal. I also want to remember here my Master Ji, Chaudhary Gauri Shankar Sagar, where I used to live for 3 years during college days. Chaudhary Gauri Shankar Sagar was the chief editor, Milab, Lahore, Jalandhar, Hyderabad, Dakkan, and after partition, even London. He was my mentor in journalism. I used to study all the newspapers which were thrown in his residence, and I got lot of knowledge in poetry and Urdu journalism. He used to come late in the evening. At night, being the chief editor, I used to open his door. I got him his beddings, etc. And he used to write poetry at midnight, which I used to read in his absence in the morning. I also pay my respects to him. He was my mentor. I am his shagird, and he gave me the title of Gurcharan Lal Josh. I asked him, "What is this?" He curiously told me, "You will not understand this Josh at this time. After 10-15 years, when you earn some name and fame, then you will say, Gauri Shankar Sagar gave me this name." And that is what I owe him. I am in debt for him. Main uska karzdar hoon aur main usko dil ki bhavna se yaad karta hoon. Yahan main ye bhi kehna chahta hoon, I want to say, and it is for record, that he was the classmate of my father, Chaudhary Manohar Lal Dutt. Both of them used to study in one kachcha kamra in the compound of our ancestral home, with one earthen pot in which 2 paise ka tel dala jata tha ek raat ko, 2 paise ka tel, aur jab wo tel khatam ho jata tha to padhai jo thi band ho jati thi. Aur uske baad they used to go to Narowal at a distance of 10 kilometers, about 8 miles, to study in 9th and 10th. And when both of them passed matriculation, my father got job first, and Chaudhary Gauri Shankar Sagar became unemployed for 2 years and wrote a history of Mohyals, which is in my possession, and I used to go through it every now and then. My father did not forget him. After 2 years, he asked him if he wants to come to Lahore. Chaudhary Gauri Shankar told him, "Manohar Lal, call me there. I will be happy to do some work." My father called him in Lahore. He was made to work in Arya Gazette with Munshi Ram Rishpal Singh, the then a very learned person of journalism. In those days, learned persons were called Munshi. Munshi Ram Rishpal Singh employed him in Arya Gazette for 3-4 years. Side by side, Chaudhary Gauri Shankar Sagar was a very young man, and his father Hargulal, who was the headman of the village, Kanjrud, he could manhandle 9 dacoits. Chaudhary Hargulal could manage to punish 9 dacoits at one time. He was such a powerful army. So Chaudhary Gauri Shankar, when came to Lahore, Giant Lahore Cricket Club, he was an associate of Lala Amarnath. During 2 years after his newspaper duty, he used to go to that Lahore Gymkhana Club, play cricket, and he was the fastest bowler of his time in 1924-25, he was the fastest bowler of the Indian 11. Then there was no England team. It was called MCC. I have lived with Chaudhary Gauri Shankar Sagar for 45, 46, 47, 3 years. I used to sleep in that house where there were photographs of Chaudhary Gauri Shankar Sagar with cups. He was 6'3" high, with the chest 48 inches, 4 foot chhati, fastest bowler. And when the first Indian team had to go to England, he was employed in the Daily Mail of Lahore as sub-editor. Mahasha Khushal Chand Khursan, who was the owner of that Milab at that time, told Chaudhary Sahab, either play cricket or do journalism. Because Chaudhary Gauri Shankar had a very, you can say, medium or average or below average background, he preferred to livelihood to cricket. That is what was in store for him. And when Chaudhary Gauri Shankar died in 72, Mehta Jamnada Sakhtar, who was one of the doyen of the Urdu journalism, paid respect on his career that Chaudhary Gauri Shankar Sagar was the best bowler of his time. But this Milab Ikhbar destroyed his career. Now I come to Kanjrud again, Lasuda. There was one Peer Saab with Safed Dadi, Safed Pagdi, with Salwar, with Kameez and Kali Jagat. They were visible only to children of 4-5 years, 6 years, 7 years, and that too in the evening or in the morning. Children were afraid of it. They were afraid of it. They used to report to my dadi ji, ke ede vich koi aadmi rehnda hai. Oh, kehndi si kuch nahi rehnda hai. Ghabrao nahi. Oh, baba ji ne. My dadi ji used to do worship on Thursday, calling Muslim boys and girls and distribute shakkar wala chawl and shakkar wala sharbat. Before I proceed further, I am sorry that I forgot to remember Baba Thakkar Di Shaheed, the founder of that dynasty. I bow my head in reverence and I regret and From the core of my heart, I feel sorry. I say sorry for 101 times. Baba Thakkar the Shaheed was the founder of Datta dynasty of Kanjrur, of which we are the children. Whenever there was any good news, Shadi, Diwali, Dussehra, Naukri, we used to go to the Samadhi of Baba Thakkar the Shaheed. The mausoleum was constructed across the Basantar Nadi, and we used to get Prashad from our Purohit Pandit Khyali Ram. Pandit Khyali Ram, with all the reverence, with all the gratitude, with all the Ashirwad, I am very sorry I forgot in the beginning to cherish his memory. Even now, say I am guilty, please pardon me. I remember Baba Thakkar the Shaheed in the morning in my prayers without fail. The story goes that Baba Thakkar the Shaheed fought the enemy across the Basantar Nadi in a headless body. Do you remember? Headless body. Gardan kat gayi thi, lekin wo gardan ke bina hi dushmanon se lad rahe thi. Some women were bathing their clothes in the Basantar Nadi. They just looked at the Baba and talked to it. How Babaji is fighting without a head. Then it is said, वो वहाँ ही समा गए और वहाँ ही समाधि बनी. तो मैं उनको पूरी श्रद्धा से, with all the reverence at my command, even my forefathers, even my mother, my father, my grandparents, everybody, the whole of Kanjur, that जितने भी हैं वो सब उनको वहाँ याद करते थे. और अब now we have brought the ashes from Kanjur to Gurdaspur. There is a mausoleum near Mandi, Gurdaspur, where the mausoleum stands, and we pay our obeisance, we pay our respects. There is a mela held on Basant Panchami every year without fail, where thousands of Dats and other parivars grace the occasion to get the blessings of Baba Thakkar the Shaheed. And as a matter of gratitude and say Charan Sparsh, while working in General Mehyal Sabha, I requested the parent body 3-4 years ago to grant 1.5 lakhs for the renovation of Shaheed Baba Thakkar Ji Maharaj. And I also wrote about him in the Mehyal Mitra with my own hands and my gratitude to him. My story is very long. It's too long. It's very long. And may continue in the times to come. मैं एक बार फिर मेरे जो बच्चे हैं, आज मैं बच्चों के बारे में कहना कुछ नहीं चाहता, बट आई वांट, बट आई वांट ऑन दिस ईव टू जस्ट थैंक एंड चेरिश एंड प्रे एंड बेग फ्रॉम यू बाबा ठक्कर दी शहीद the almighty god, my mother, my father, my grandparents, my nana nani ji, if my daughter Prabha is a blessing in disguise for me. When she was born I was homeless, but after 4 months of her birth, I requested my boss. I also want to remember him, Shri R. K. Chaudhary. I went to him at 10 o'clock in the night at Bandar Mark. It was called Rattendan Road at that time, 40 Rattendan Road. He was so much influenced about my work and conduct. When I called his bell, he came out. He used to love me as his son. He told me, "Beta, as well as 10 baje aa gaye." So I just became a little bit emotional. I said, "Sir, I don't have any house to live in. Sometimes I live in the house of my relative, sometimes I live in the house of my Masi ji. I have no house of my own." Kehne laga, "Beta, don't stop this. Don't be emotional. On 26th of March, on 26th of March, I remember the date, house is going to be vacant at Teen Murti. Move in to that house. And I want to say, from 26th of March onward, I am living in my own roof and in my own house. God bless Prabha. And I also want to say, on her birth, I enjoyed so much of reputation, so much of glory, so much of fame. I became an inspector thereafter. I became an inspector and became an inspector. और मेरी माँ जो थी वो इतना खुश थी जिसका कोई हिसाब नहीं है. माई मदर यूज टू डोनेट मनी ऑन द बर्थ ऑफ फीमेल चाइल्ड, मिडवाइफ, नर्स, डॉक्टर, लड्डू. माई मदर यूज टू लुक आफ्टर माई वाइफ very much. She loved her. She didn't consider her daughter-in-law. She loved her. She was very happy to see the family. She loved her. She nursed her. She nursed my wife. She kept her healthy. She kept her happy. She gave everything. To her, even at the death of my mother, she called my wife and gave her all her currency notes to her, not to me, not to me. I want to remember my in-laws also. My father-in-law was a nobleman. He never said he is my son-in-law. No. He never be termed as son-in-law. Never said term me as son-in-law. I will keep on talking like this in the days to come. God bless Prabha. और मैं तो ये कहूँगा कि एक शेर मुझे याद आ गया है. वो शेर ये है कि रास्ते का चिराग हूँ मैं. अब मैं शेर पढ़ने से पहले ना थोड़ी इसकी व्याख्या करना चाहता हूँ. लड़की जब शादी हो जाती है तो लड़की ना ससुराल जाती है. तो जब ससुराल जाती है ना तो वो दरवाजे में खड़े होके ना फुलियाँ पीछे को फेंकती है ना. उसका मतलब ये होता है कि मेरे माँ बाप जो हैं पैसे देने से राजी खुशी रहें. मतलब है इनको पैसा देला काफ़ी, परमात्मा दे दौलत दे इनको राजी खुशी रखे. नंबर वन. नंबर टू, जब दिवाली होती है तो घर की औरतें एक चिराग थाली में रखकर चौरस्ते में जाती हैं और चौरस्ते में जाके वो एक दिया जला के आते हैं. वो क्यों? वो इसलिए जला के आते हैं कि रात को जब दरवाज़ा हम बंद कर दें तो जो लक्ष्मी ने आना है, लक्ष्मी को हमारे घर का रास्ता नज़र आ जाए और वो हमारे घर में आके वो जो थाली में हमने पैसे बखेरे हुए हैं उसमें वो जो लक्ष्मी है वो आके जो हमने पूजा की है वहाँ इस घर को और लक्ष्मी दे जाए. तो देखिए लड़की भी देती है पैसा धन, और जो घर की बहू है या जो लेडी ऑफ द हाउस है वो भी वो जो पैसा है उसके लिए दुआ करती. तो मैंने उन दोनों से, लड़की से भी और वाइफ से भी कुछ सीखा है. तो मैं एक शेर रिकॉर्ड करना चाहता हूँ और मैं मतलब ही समझाऊंगा. रास्ते का चिराग समझते हो ना मामूली. रास्ते का चिराग हूँ मैं, सूरज नहीं हूँ मैं. सूरज सारी दुनिया को रोशनी देता है ना, लेकिन चिराग जो है वो टिमटिमाता रास्ता ही दिखाता है ना. तो रास्ते का चिराग हूँ मैं, सूरज नहीं हूँ मैं. जितनी मेरी बसात है काम आ रहा हूँ. बसात कहते हैं कैपेसिटी, है ना, कैपेसिटी, या उर्दू में कहते हैं औकात, या हिंदी में कहते हैं क्षमता. तो मैं मामूली आदमी हूँ. तो सुरेश जी का ख़ास तौर पे और प्रभा जी तो मेरे लिए ये कभी कभी आजकल मुझे ना थोड़ा जैसे किसी को ट्रेनिंग सेंटर में समझाते हैं ना कि भी ऐसे नहीं ऐसे कर समझाती है. तो आई डोंट माइंड इट. बुज़ुर्ग भी तो कई दफ़ा गलती कर जाते हैं, बच्चे भी कर जाते हैं. तो इसलिए अगर मेरे से बोलने में किसी भी व्यक्ति विशेष से कोई गुस्ताखी हो गई हो तो मैं नहायत आजजी से, इज्जत से, आजजी से, इज्जत से, इत्राम से झुककर माफी मांगता हूँ। और एक मेरा एक शेर है, शेर नहीं है ये मेरा, देखिए मैं हमेशा अपने बुजुर्गों को याद रखता हूँ। वो बुजुर्ग जिन्होंने जनरल मोहयाल सभा को बनाया, और वो बुजुर्ग जो हमारे कंजूर के तमाम बुजुर्ग थे 1539 से, जब बाबर ने हमें कंजूर को वक्फ दिया था, 408 साल हमने वहाँ गुजारे, उन सब का धन्यवाद करता हूँ। और एक कथा उन बुजुर्गों के लिए मैं पढ़ता हूँ, वो भी रिकॉर्ड हो जाए तो अच्छा है। जो कौम बुजुर्गों के बताए हुए रास्ते पे चली है, जो कौम बुजुर्गों के बताए हुए रास्ते पे चली है, वो कौम सदा ज़माने में फूली फली है, वो कौम सदा ज़माने में फूली फली है। और करते रहो हरदम तुम याद उन्हीं को, और करते रहो हरदम तुम याद उन्हीं को, शिक्षा यही जोश को बुजुर्गों से मिली है, शिक्षा यही जोश को बुजुर्गों से मिली।